Non metals like graphite, sulfur, mica, gypsum, and also materials like marble, granite, sandstone, limestone, and precious and semi-precious stones like diamonds, rubies, sapphires, emeralds, topaz, jade, etc. are non-renewable natural resources.
Tai, am I right to say that many of these materials obtained from non-renewable natural resources are costly because of their resources are exhaustible?
Yes, you are absolutely right. Non-renewable natural resources are getting consumed and depleted at faster rate than they are being reformed and replenished in nature. So, they are exhaustible, leading to increase in their cost.
Oh. Bhai, is water a natural resource?
Yes, indeed. And the most valuable, I can say. Can you imagine life without water?
Of course not. Is it a renewable or a non-renewable resource?
You tell me.
Okay, let me see. We get water from wells, lakes, rivers, seas and oceans. But the water in them is replenished every year with rainfall in monsoon season. So, I think water is a renewable natural resource and not non-renewable.
And you are absolutely right. Well, do you know water not only sustains all living organisms, but we also use it for generation of electricity? Electricity is the energy we use to run most of our appliances like refrigerators, geysers, air conditioners, TV sets, computers, microwave ovens, fans and light bulbs, to name a few.
Which are other renewable natural resources used to generate electricity?
Air, wind and sunlight. These are other renewable natural resources used for generation of electricity. Water, air, wind and sunlight are commonly called as abiotic, that is non-living renewable natural resources.
Okay. Then what are living or biotic renewable natural resources surrounding us?
Well, all living organisms present in air, water and soil, which includes vast varieties of microorganisms, plants and animals, constitute biotic renewable natural resource surrounding us. All living beings on this planet die, but their populations are replenished regularly because all living organisms also undergo reproduction to produce more of their own kind.
But how are living organisms a resource for us?
Isn't it obvious? Apart from water, which is essential for life, we also require food to survive and grow, right? Where do we get our food from?
Okay, now I get it. We get foodstuffs like fruits, vegetables, grains, cereals, pulses, milk, eggs, meat, oils, spices, etc. from the plants and animals.
Yes, you're right. And apart from food materials, we obtain variety of other materials like wood, paper, wool, cotton, leather, herbs, honey, medicines and many more such products are obtained from living organisms. So, all the living organisms are important natural resources that we use to make our lives easier.
Oh, nice. I never thought of this. Now, when we learn this chapter in our school, I will be able to answer all of the questions asked by our teacher.
Well, that's great, but please do read the chapter well from textbook, okay? And in case you have any doubts, you can ask me or your teacher.
Yes, I will. Now, can I go to play outside?
Okay. Go now, but be back before lunchtime, huh?
Yes. Okay, bye.
Bye.